Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, Senior XD Evangelist at Adobe. With another Max in the books, let's take a look at some of the brand new Adobe XD features that just shipped, including states with hover, co-editing, document history, multiple interaction support, and more. Back in May, we upgraded symbols to components, which brought resizability and overrides. And today, we're supercharging them even further by adding in states. As you start building out the various components you'll be including throughout your projects, you may also want to create different versions that you can quickly switch to depending on the situation. Now, when you convert elements into a component, you can build out additional states, just like you would when overriding instances. Then switch to them with a click of the mouse. Hover states can also be created, and to make your life easier, they're automatically wired up. So once you've made your adjustments and have the default state active, previewing your prototype will let you hover to your heart's content. Of course, states also work great with Auto Animate. For the search interaction on this screen, I've created an additional state where the magnify glass has been extended and the handle turns into the text caret. Switching over to prototype mode, I can wire it up, but instead of dragging the handle to another artboard, I'm simply going to click on it. Now, within the properties, I'll want to make sure that tap is the trigger and Auto Animate is the action. I can then choose which state will be transitioned to when tapped, in this case, the extended state. Finally, I'll make sure my easing and duration options are set. Before I preview, I may also want to set up a quick trigger from the second state back to the first. Perfect. Previewing this artboard, I can now click on the search icon to transition to the expanded text box, and then click again to collapse it. Being able to transition between states on a single artboard will be a massive benefit to some of you. Previously, I would have needed 21 artboards just to show off the various interactions on this screen, but now it's all consolidated into one. If you want to dive deeper into states, I just released a brand new video and UI kit, which you can download over at letsxd.com/states. Co-editing in Adobe XD lets you work right alongside your colleague John, and Tammy, Marissa, Frederick, Karen, and Kim, and the other designers, copy editors, and creative directors you work with. To get started, make sure your document is saved to the cloud, then enable it for co-editing. You can now start inviting members of your team who you'd like to collaborate with, and as they join the document, they'll appear up at the top. If you're feeling adventurous, you can all get cozy and work on the same artboard, or split up duties and tackle various screens and tasks to speed up your workflows. Document history is also available, allowing you and your team to save snapshots of important milestones, or if Chris happens to delete an artboard or two, you can travel back in time and retrieve it. As you start to bring your designs to life and expand upon your prototypes, you may find yourself wanting the ability to wire up multiple triggers from a single object. A gallery, for example. I may want a user to not only swipe through to the next card, but also tap on it if they choose. Hopping into prototype mode, I'll select the card that I want a user to drag, and then pull the blue handle over to the artboard where the second is visible. Within the properties, I can set up a drag trigger with Auto Animate. I can then repeat the process so the first card can be dragged back into view. Checking out the preview, I can swipe to the second card and back to the first. Great, but I also want users to be able to expand this card with a tap. Selecting the first group one more time, I'll now see a plus button, which can be pulled to an additional artboard to create a second trigger, or since I have an expanded state set up for this component, I can click instead. For this trigger, I'll select tap, make sure that Auto Animate is the action, and choose the state I wish to transition to. Now that I have an additional trigger set up, I can quickly switch between them to make edits if necessary. Previewing one more time, I can drag like I did a moment ago, but I can now also tap to expand the card. This same technique can also be used to wire up multiple voice, key, or gamepad triggers all from a single object instead of spreading them around your artboards. XD24 also includes an improved share experience, the ability to import your sketch libraries, better management of your Creative Cloud assets, and more ways to discover and manage plugins. I'll be covering many of these additional features very soon. And that's a look at a few of the new features we just shipped for Adobe XD, all available right now. If you're just beginning your XD journey, head on over to letsxd.com, and I'll see you all soon.